Hello and welcome to my first video on this channel. Today, we are going to discuss about Postgres joins, and at the end of this video, you will have a greater understanding of all kinds of joins in Postgres. In a relational database, data is stored in tables using columns and rows. The structure of tables in a relational database is rigid and well-defined. As an example, in the database of a workplace, the employees table will be structured to only contain data for an employee, while the departments table will contain data for their departments. Most times, we may need to get a piece of information that may be contained in multiple tables. For example, we may wish to get the names of each employee and their respective departments in the company. To achieve this, we will make use of joins, a way of retrieving data across multiple tables. To understand joins, you will need to know about primary keys and foreign keys. A primary key is a special column or set of columns that uniquely identifies each row in the table. It is unique for each row and cannot be empty. It serves as a reference for establishing relationships with other tables. In the employees table, the primary key is the employee ID, while that of the department is the department ID. To establish a relation between a row in table A and a row in table B, there needs to be a column in table A that contains the primary keys of the corresponding rows in table B. This is called a foreign key. For example, in the employees table, we may need a relation between each employee and their respective departments. Therefore, we need to have a column that contains the primary keys of the employees department. In the employees table, we have the department ID as the foreign key, which links the primary key of the department's table. The type of join just demonstrated is called an inner join. We shall discuss the following types of joins: inner join, left join, right join, full outer join, self join, cross join, and the natural join. On a side note, if you wish to follow this tutorial practically, every SQL code used in this video is in a GitHub Gist. The link can be found in the description. To create the tables needed for the workplace database, we make use of this. To populate the data, we make use of this. So how does an inner join work? When we perform an inner join between tables A and B, it compares each row in table A to each row in table B using a join condition. In the employees department's case, the join condition is if the department ID in the employees table matches that of the departments. It iterates through each row in table A and compares with each row in table B. When there is a match, it creates a row with the requested fields from both tables and adds to the results. If a row in A matches with multiple rows in B, they are all added as new rows in the result. When a row in A has no match with any row in B, it does nothing and moves to the next row. We can also have joins between three or more tables. For example, to get the project John Doe is working on, we have to join with the employee project assignment table and the projects table. Each join will have its own condition and it will compare each row using their respective join condition. An SQL command for an inner join between the employees and departments table is given as such. First, we write the select keyword and impute the fields we like to retrieve from both tables. For fields that have a common name in both the employees and departments table, like the department ID, we differentiate by specifying them as employees.departmentID for employees, and for the departments table, we write as departments.departmentID. But in this scenario, the names of the fields we need to retrieve are not common to both tables. Next, we specify the primary table we wish to retrieve the data using the from keyword, followed by the table name. Then we add the inner join command followed by the table name we wish to perform the join on. We need to specify the condition in which a row from table A is to be joined with a row from table B. In our case, we need the department ID from the employees table to match the department ID from the departments table. So we add the on keyword followed by the condition. Since the join condition depends on the equality of the department ID, which has the same name in both employees and departments table, we can specify these by making use of the using keyword followed by the common field names in parentheses. So when we run our SQL command to get the details for the employees and their departments, we get the following rows. So what particularly is a left join and how is this different from an inner join? Just as an inner join, when comparing each row of both tables, if a row in A matches with a row in B, it creates a row with the requested fields from both tables and adds to the result. If there are multiple matches in B for a single row in A, it adds a row in the result for each match. In an inner join, when there are no match, nothing is done. But in a left join, it creates a row with the needed fields from table A and adds null for the fields needed in B. Let's say we have two more employees without a specified department. An inner join would consider those in the result, but a left join would consider all rows in the left table to be in the result. For a right join, it takes table B as a primary table. It compares each row in B with rows in A, and where there is no match, the row added to the result will contain details from the second table, while adding null for data needed from the first table. If we add a new department like technical support in the departments table, it is included in the result but adds null for all employees columns. A right join is the opposite of a left join. A right join isn't commonly used, as a left join can be used in its place with the table swapped. The SQL command for a left join is similar to that of an inner join, but instead of an inner join, we write a left join, and likewise write for a right join. If we wish to get all employees that aren't assigned to a department, we restrict the left join SQL command to where the department name is null in the left join. To get all departments without employees, we restrict the right join SQL query to where the employee name is null in the right join. A full outer join is a combination of a left join and a right join. When there is no matching row for a row in the first table, a row is added with the data for the fields from the first table and null for the fields in the second table. Likewise, when there is no matching row for a row in the second table, a row is added with the data for the fields in the second table and null for the fields in the first. The SQL query for a full outer join is given as such. To get all employees without a department and departments without employees, we restrict to where the employee name is null or department name is null. Using this data, we can assign free employees to empty departments. A self-join is a join between the same table. The join can be a left, right, or an inner join. It is mostly used for comparing data in the same table. Let's say we wish to list out each employee with their respective colleagues in the same department. We use a join between the employees table and itself. Here, the join condition is if two employees have the same department ID. To write the SQL query for a self-join, you will need a table and column alias. An alias is a temporal name given to a table or column for the duration of the query. This can be used to differentiate between two tables or columns with the same name. For the left employee table, we give it an alias of E1 and an alias of E2 for the second table. For the SQL query, since we have to differentiate the first table and second table in the query, we use table aliases. For the left employee table, we aliased with E1 and the second with E2. So to get the employee name from the first table, we use E1.EmployeeName and the colleague name with E2.EmployeeName. So with this, we have our SQL query looking like this. The result, we have the employee name as the column names for both tables. So to differentiate the employee name from the colleague, we use column aliases. We use employee for E1.EmployeeName and colleague for E2.EmployeeName. Every employee is their own colleague since they have the same department ID. But to prevent this, we make sure that every two employee in consideration shouldn't be the same by adding that the E1 and E2 employee IDs are not equal in the join condition. This will give us a list of each employee and their colleague, which will look like the table on the right. A cross join, also called a Cartesian join, is a join between two tables without any join condition. It returns every possible combination of rows between two tables. It matches each row in A with each row in B. The resulting data is like a Cartesian product of the two tables. A cross join between the employees and departments table will list out every possible combination of employees and departments. The SQL query for the cross join looks like this. A cross join can also be achieved by using true as the join condition for any other kind of join. A natural join is a type of join operation that does not require explicitly specifying a join condition. Instead, it automatically identifies and joins table based on columns with matching names. In the employees and departments table, a natural join will find common column names. In this case, it's the department ID. It then matches each row if their department IDs are equal. In the SQL query for a natural join, after the select keyword, we write out the fields we need from both tables, followed by a natural join between the two tables. A natural join uses an inner join by default. To use a left join, we specify by using a natural left join keyword or natural right join for a right join. We don't specify a join condition here, as a natural join will join on the equality of common column names. If there are no common column names, our result will be similar to that of the cross join, listing out every possible combination of the rows. The natural join is beneficial since it's simple, convenient, and avoids redundancy by not repeating column names in the join condition. This is very noticeable when we want to perform a join in three or more tables. To see its convenience come into play, let's say we wish to get all employees with the projects they are currently working on. Here, we need a left join between the three tables, the employees table, the employees assignment tables, and the projects table. Using a left join, we will use the following SQL query, but with a natural left join, it is reduced to this. The result we get from the join will look like this. Thanks for watching. Check out my web games at kodi.dev/games and enjoy the rest of your day. The link is in the description. Please give this a like and share your thoughts and questions in the comments below. You can check out my emails and socials in the description below. And also, please consider subscribing. Have a nice day.